I was in Baltimore and I came across this massage tool. I had like really ongoing bad problems with my back because it's really long and thin. I had found this massage tool. It's called a mild roller, and it's shaped like this. I used the massage tool, and a couple of days later, my face broke out. And I realized that it was because, you know, one of the things that I was doing, holding myself tight because of my back problems, I was holding toxins. And the mild roller had caused those toxins to be released. And I had to be appreciative, because even though I didn't like what the face, the skin on my face was looking at, like at that moment, it was important for me to know that I had toxins and to begin to cleanse those toxins out of my system. Donald Trump is a mild roller. When Obama was elected president, people started saying we're in this post-racial society, right? And you know, anybody who was not white certainly knew that that was not the case. But because we had this black president figure, we were undermined in our ability, you know, in our efforts to really speak for it and work for the equality that we still were not, you know, receiving. And Donald Trump has eradicated that. He has, you know, people are talking about how, you know, Donald Trump has given validity and given, you know, to all these races, but, you know, what he did is he helped them step out. He brought it to the forefront so we can actually continue to be honest about the healing that we need to do. You know, and that's important. So Donald Trump is an important gift to our community in that regard. And I'm grateful for Donald Trump for that, because we need to get to the healing, right? And, you know, so there's the reality of the racism and all the different forms of oppression that we've been dealing with in this country, and, you know, across the world, but we're talking about here. And we, as the black community, have a history, you know, a permanent history with that so far. And one of the things that we know a lot about is the difference between overt racism and covert racism. And the overt races are much easier to deal with. When you know that there's a person who is explicitly being honest about the fact that they don't want you to have equality, you know what your fight is, you know who you're battling against, it's much more difficult to do when that individual is pretending. And we have covert races all throughout our system. And we have one who is the lead candidate for one of the major parties. That is what Hillary Clinton is. If you look at Hillary Clinton's policies, and you look at what she's done over the course of time that she has been empowered, what you see is that Donald Trump is her mouthpiece. What he says is what's in her heart. We know what's in her heart based on what she does. What she does is she takes the land of people, of poor black people in Haiti, so that they can't farm for themselves, and requires them to have to import things that they used to actually provide for their own community, builds factories on those lands, and then forces those people to work 70 hours a week in those factories at 31 cents an hour. And it's only they were going to take it to that 31 cents an hour. And she also, as the so-called not racist candidate, also took the gold mine and gave the only access to that gold mine to her brother. What she does is she goes and she takes and she moves our half African president to go into that African country of Libya and destroy that African country because that leader had the nerve to want to empower the continent of Africa to actually be a resource for the people of Africa. And the exact white supremacists are out of the way. That's racism that has cost millions of people's lives and has destroyed millions of families. That's the same racism that, and we talk about the concerns for Muslims, and you know, we have someone like Donald Trump who wants to build a wall, wants to keep Muslims out, and we have Hillary Clinton dropping bombs on Muslims all over the world. Wednesday that I was talking about that with the brother who I met earlier when we went to the wrong location first, and we were walking over here, and we're talking about how these people are so comfortable, they're afraid of Donald Trump because you can't ignore what he is. But people are finding it very comfortable and to go ahead and ignore what Hillary Clinton is, wow, instead of go ahead and fight. They want to stay in this safe place, you know, and people talk about privilege. They talk about, you know, they try to say that you are using white privilege or you're connected to your white privilege if you decide that you want to vote for the person who's actually willing to stand up for everyone's rights. If you actually want to we created in their country. And so all of their rights are so important. We can't
I'm finding so many different mentalities. It seems challenging. I don't say hard because the only thing hard is the kind of creep that you walk on. Everything else is a challenge. So I'm ready for this challenge. And I was built.